Hi everyone, my name is Pragnya and I'm just going to be playing you one of my songs. This one's called Free Hugs. Alone I stand on the corner streets, expressionless passing eyes. I bear my heart and soul to you, I'm wearing no disguise, no war. Won't ask you any questions, I won't offer you no advice. My heart is open for anyone, this is real, no device, no device. Nothing in return. You may be brown, black or white. Well, it's dark and some hearts burn. Let's all spread a little light, broken heart to mend. Needing a shoulder to cry or another comfort of a friend. I ask not where you come from, I ask not where you go. The glimmer of sadness in your eyes speaks all there is to know. Oh, yeah. Free hugs, nothing in return. You may be brown, black or white. Well, it's dark and some hearts burn. Let's all spread a little light. The frowns turn upside down, the teardrops disappear. As your hand reaches out for mine, the dark skies start to clear. Yay. Our hearts heal together, shadows creep away. Heaven's arms are open, the dark cloud starts to fray. Nothing in return. You may be brown, black or white. Well, it's dark and some hearts burn. Let's all spread a little. Let's all spread a little light. Thank you.
Hello and welcome back to India Post Live, India's first online live news interactive conversation web portal. Well, as you all know, India Post Live is your very own platform where you too can participate on various range of issues that we are discussing by simply sending us your participation request. I'm Hisayama Bhutia. Joining me today on this musical Friday afternoon is a solo artist based out of Delhi. She's from Gurgaon. Well, she's a songwriter, an instrumentalist, and a singer, Pragnya Waklu. Welcome to India Post Live, Pragnya.
Thank you very much for having me on your show. Yeah. It's an absolute pleasure to be here today.
Yeah, you've got a very interesting name, but a very difficult one to pronounce, I must say.
Yeah, you'll have to thank my parents for that.
Yeah, we'll. Your father is online. We'll just start talking to him. But before I get your dad online, you know, very interesting thing about you is that you know, you were working in America before you came back to India to pursue your passion. That's very interesting. How did that come by, you know, like leaving a very high paying job in America and then suddenly coming back to India as a you know, musician?
Yeah.
How did that come by?
So, I was working initially in the IT field in America, and, you know, after a while, I started feeling that my purpose on earth is meant to be more than just, you know, coding for a fashion retailer. I was working for a fashion retailer, and I really felt a strong urge to come back to the country and do something more with the people here, and also utilize my talents to help make a difference in society. So my main, I knew I wanted to do something with music and working with people and something to do with social change. So how it was all going to come together, I didn't know. So I came back to India, and then I actually started, you know, like I formed a band, and then actually my dad and mom, they asked me to do a little project with them for, you know, working with music, how can we use music and movement to bring about change? So I did a bit of research in that area. And then I started also performing with a band, and I really like writing songs which help to inspire, uplift people, because I believe there's already too much negativity in the world, so why not just, you know, put in some more positive energy out there through music,
So Pranay, how has it been for you, you know, living, you know, if you do you think like at some point of time that if you would have stayed back in US and pursued this passion, you would have become more successful than, you know, compared to, you know, being in India? Do you, because we know the music scene in India, the band scene in India.
No, actually, I believe that I mean, I knew I would be more successful here because there's extreme high amount of competition in America, and there are a lot of more, you know, women musicians who are extremely talented there. Whereas in India, people are still starting to regard music as a profession. So far, I mean, for many years, it was just considered as a hobby. And to make music as a profession is relatively, over the last maybe 7-8 years, people have, it's growing in India. The independent music scene has definitely like grown a lot in India. And now is the best time to be in India during the boom of the indie music scene. So I knew that, you know, at least at the time when I left for US, there weren't many women musicians playing the guitar and performing. So I knew it would be a unique factor as well. So, and that is true, because after I came back, I mean, there are not so many women musicians playing the guitar on the indie circuit. And so it is, I mean, it has helped me also.
Okay. So Pragna, we'll just get your father online, Mr. Arun Vaklu.
And my mom's there as well.
Yeah, welcome to India Post Live, sir.
Thank you very much. Thanks, Sam.
Hello. Can you hear us, sir? Okay, so Nikita is also online. Hello? Okay, so we'll just get back to them. I think this seems to be a bit connection problem. Okay, so Nikita is back.
Nikita, yeah, you go ahead with Nikita and then we'll come in.
Okay, so we'll just get back to you, yes?
No problem, go ahead.
Yeah, so Nikita, you know Pragna, right?
Oh, we can't hear our audio.
We can't hear your audio. Can you unmute your mic? Can you unmute your mic? Okay, so Nikita, we'll just get back to you. So, sir, we were talking about, you know, just before we got cut off, we were talking about her, you know, journey, quitting her job in US and coming back to India. So what was your first reaction when Pragna told you about her decision to come back to India and, you know, pursue her dream?
Yes. So, you know, I think one of the things that Anu and I have always believed in is that you must follow your heart. You must listen to your deepest calling and just stay true to that, because that's when the best comes out. And we just therefore encouraged her to follow her heart. And it was her passion for music. And we just trusted that creative intelligence in her. And God be thanked, she's doing great. So quite happy about that.
Wow. She's been truly blessed with such wonderful parents. Yeah. I mean, so you must be really proud of Pragna.
Yeah, absolutely. Very proud of her. And I think what touches me most is that her songs come from the soul. They come from a very deep space. And her creativity also comes from a very compassionate and sacred inner space. And I think that's the greatest gift that a parent can receive, is to see your child blossoming on those lines. So we're very proud of you, Pragna, and thanks. Very happy with what she's doing.
That's my mom, by the way, in the back.
Okay, that's her mother there. Hi, ma'am.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. So, sir, yeah. Well, you being a father, I know that it's a difficult question, but do you have that one particular song of Pragna which you really like and, you know, would want her to play right now?
Well, there's a song called Rising High. It's about a bumblebee that thought that it couldn't fly, and then it found that, you know, by changing one's beliefs, it could rise very high. And I think that's a beautiful song. Of course, there are many, but that just came to my mind right now, and it might be liked by some of your listeners on the show right now. And before we hear the song, really proud of you folks on India Positive, and keep up the good work. Very, very happy about what you're doing.
So it's India Post Live, sir.
Sorry?
It's India Post Live.
Yes, India Post. India Post. That's what I mean. India
okay,
Post.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much for your kind words. Thank you so much. Well, right. Pragna, please. Yeah. Your father's just made a request, so please.
Sure. Okay.
Can you tell us something about the song?
Yeah. I'll just 1 second. Yeah, so this song is basically about a bumblebee. Mm-hmm. It's called Flying High. And it's basically, if you see a bee, you'll see that his body is big and his wings are kind of tiny in comparison. And this song is about, according to the laws of physics, he's not supposed to be able to take flight. But he doesn't, no one's told him that, and he still flies anyway. So this song is about, you know, sometimes we often limit ourselves to our own growth because of our own beliefs in our heads, or what somebody tells you, you can't do something and you believe them. But you break free from that and just fly high, and that's what, be like the bumblebee.
So that's what even your dad has let you do, just fly high.
Yeah, actually my mom and dad are both very supportive, and thanks to them, if I didn't have parents like them, I wouldn't be like where I am right now.
Wow. That's really cute.
Yeah. So this is a song, Flying High.
Yeah. Sorry.
They said he couldn't fly. His body too big, his wings too small. So he
Lovely, lovely was you. Such you got such beautiful voice.
Thank
I can
you.
See that now. Why your parents are so proud of you?
Thanks, thank you.
Okay, so Pragna, we are joined online by Nikita. Nikita, are you there? Can you unmute the mic, Nikita?
Oh, I think her audio settings are.
Yeah. Like can you unmute your mic?
She's saying 1 second.
Yeah. Okay.
I think we have some other guys online as well, so I can check it.
You're not able to. Okay, Nikita. Till the time you figure out to unmute your mic, we'll just get back to Pragna's dad. Hello, sir.
Yes. Yes, I'm here. Please go ahead.
So yeah. So you just. I can see that now. You know why you're so proud of your daughter, and why you know that she's blessed to have such parents who stood by her. You know, and then you know because it was a big decision for her to move from there to India.
Absolutely. Yeah. 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 And I think India needs young people like Pragna and you and many others to create a positive impact in the nation. So I think we are a young nation, and I think if as Pragna's song said, if we can break out of the patterns of our mind, self-limiting beliefs, and become more positive, India will be the, you know, the shining nation that it's destined to be.
And I would like to say that India needs parents like you.
Thank you.
For a shining tomorrow.
Thank you so much. And also, I think the other thing is to also use a lot of music and songs to stir hearts. So thank you for doing what you're doing.
So yeah, that's why we believe in music. Music has no language. It's a very powerful tool. So that's what we believe in India Post Live.
Absolutely. Very nice. Very, very proud of all of you.
Thank you. So we'll just get back to you, sir.
For sure.
Okay, so Pragna, you released your debut solo album in 2012.
Yeah.
That's called Journey to the Sun.
Sun.
I have a copy of the album.
Yeah.
It's Journey to the Sun. Please, if you have not picked the album, please go ahead and do not download and buy the album. Yeah. So tell us a bit about Journey to the Sun. What is it all about?
So basically, the song, the album has 7 songs.
Mm-hmm.
And each of them I've collaborated with different artists across India to try to get a divergent sound.
Mm-hmm.
And actually the album was conceived at the time where I was making a personal journey transition in my life journey from, you know, being IT engineer to a musician and entrepreneur. Yeah. So a lot of them are very reflective of my personal journey. And why it's called Journey to the Sun is because the sun is a place of light and a symbol of like prosperity and shining, like a vision. So this I named it that because I felt that this is the first step on my journey towards that the sun, which is basically the ultimate goal of whatever I want to do. So the first song which I wrote, Knife, is actually a collaboration. I wrote it, it's the second song on the album.
Mm-hmm.
And we have a sarod player, Prashik, a friend of mine, who actually played the sarod on that track.
Mm-hmm.
So it has a nice sort of fusion sound, and that track was nominated for the best in the Jima Awards recently.
Yeah, in the Jima Awards, yeah.
So that, and also it got several nominations at the Southeast Asian Music Awards, Jack Daniels Awards as well. So I think that track seems to have worked very well.
Can you play that out for us?
Yeah,
just a small,
sure.
I'll just
play one verse of that track.
Yeah, please.
And actually, the sarod, unfortunately, Prashik's not here.
Yeah.
So you'll have to imagine the sarod bits. But yeah, I'll play it for you. It's incidentally Niketa's favorite track. Niketa, who's online also.
Oh, yeah.
Who I hope she gets her mic kind of sorted out. But she, actually, when I first wrote this song before recording it, I wasn't really sure if, you know, it's a song that's going to work and stuff. And I made her listen to it. And then she said that it's nice. She liked it. And I recorded a demo. And then I actually recorded it in a studio and everything.
So we'll dedicate this song to Niketa. So,
yeah.
So, you know, she's there hanging on, trying to talk to us, but I don't know, you know. So, Nikita, this is for you.
Hey, you, when I was was a child. Did you show me dreams of butterflies? Shiny rainbows and stars, or wasn't I naive? Didn't you tell me that I could be whatever I wanted when I grew up? Now I'm 24 and I feel my work has no meaning. Each day I wake up with the same feeling. What the hell is going on with me? Is this really what I want to be? Break these chains and set me free.
Wow, beautiful. You are one talent. Right now, me sitting here, I really envy you. Like, I wish I could sing like Pragnya. I wish I could play like her. So, Nikita, that was for you. So, sorry. Are you there? Okay. Okay, she's still having trouble with the audio. Anyway, so, any albums planning soon, are you?
Yeah. Incidentally, I think just for a minute, we had Puneet online.
Yeah, Puneet was there for some time, but
yeah, so he was actually the guy who mixed and mastered the album. Did a really good job on it. So yeah, the future plans are that I'm currently working with a band. We formed a band in Delhi called Fruzu, and we've recorded one track. We're recording another one, and it's more like a funk rock thing. So that's with the band. And on a personal note, like as a side project, I'm also working on how can we really bring the Kashmiri language back to people speaking?
I was just coming to that. Yeah, please go ahead.
Yeah, so I mean, my vision is to help me. First of all, I'm also not extremely fluent in the language, to be honest. I speak Kashmiri, but I would like to be better at it. And also, we had a discussion earlier that, it's nice to get back in touch with your roots.
Yeah, get back to your roots, yeah.
Yeah. So, this is actually an attempt at helping to popularize the Kashmiri language and also to, bring some of the work of a lot of Sufi saints and all to the fore. So that I translate a few of them, create new material so that people, when they listen to a song and they like the melody, then they try to find out what does this mean, and that itself will lead to a quest
that leads to another
exploration,
and then you learn, right?
Yeah, so that's a great way to learn. And for decades, we've been using music in Germany and India as a form of learning a language. I felt that this would be a good medium for people to get in touch with the Kashmiri language more, and also to be exposed to a bit of what's I want to especially do it because there's of late been a lot of in the political scenario as well that people from Kashmir are making music and then they're getting threats and all that. So I don't want I don't want it to stop people from making music, so I also want to do this as a form of making like an example for other people to also start working more and continue.
Can you play that for us?
Yeah, sure. So this is a song.
It's in Kashmiri, right?
Yeah. It's actually, I'm still working on completing it, but it's a song by a poetess called, I'll give you a little background. So there was a king called Yusuf Shachak in 16th century Kashmir. And there was a poetess called Haba Khatun. And the king fell in love with the poetess. And then he was captured by the Mughals and taken to Agra. So she really missed him, and then she wrote this song, like some words for him. And I've kind of improvised it with a guitar and made a little tune.
Yeah, please, let's hear it.
Yeah. So eventually when the song is complete, there'll be a couple of English translations as well. For now, I'll play the Kashmiri part.
Yeah, please, Kashmiri, I would love to hear that.
Chuk nund bane valo mahashok myane valo mahashok myane kathyu chuk nund bane valo mahashok myane kathyu chuk nund bane शराब के प्याल भरियो गुलाबन मल करियो पगाया कल मरियो कत्यु चुक नुंद बहाने वलो महाशोक म्याने कत्यु चुक नुंद बहाने सूरत चक चपरी से शूबी जाम जरी हाँ बसूरत चक चपरी से शूबी जाम जरी कम्यूत वीज करी बलो माशोक म्याने गत्यु छुक नुंद बाने
Well, thank you, Pragnya. Thank you so much for coming to India Post Live. I mean, I have to wrap up the show, though, as I don't want to, but we have run out of time. Thank you so much. We wish you all the best from on behalf of India Post Live. Thank you so much. I would also like to thank my online guest, Mr. Arun Vaklu. And Manu and so well, that's all we have for you on this show. What do you think of Pragnya Vaklu? Send us your feedback and comments on www.indiapostlive.com. You can also send us your tweets to hashtag India Post Live or @IndiaPostLive. You can also go to our Facebook page and post your comments there. Thank you for watching the show. Stay tuned for more.